Good morning, Life Center family. It's my joy to be with you again to share another daily devotion with you. My thoughts during this time are just perspective. What is the perspective of faith for my heart and looking for where is God in the midst of this chaos or the trial that we're facing globally? And my heart is turned to, you know, the canvas of creation. You know, if I were God, I would set like blank white space, beautiful scenery, and into that I would begin to do, you know, creative space. Creative people need a creative space to work with. But God works in it's a completely the opposite way. He picked a canvas that was dark. It was the description of the canvas was darkness and void. I didn't even know what void, the definition of void is in the midst of darkness, you know? And so in this seemingly nothingness, in this chaotic environment of deep darkness and void, he speaks his brilliant light into existence, and then all of creation becomes into being through the sound of his voice. So my heart, during the chaos that we're facing, I see it as darkness covering the face of the earth, but there is an invitation in the midst of that. Darkness is the canvas for the light of God, and this is what we're facing right now. So I want to encourage you from Isaiah 60, because it references the same perspective. Here's what it says. It's an invitation. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. For behold, here's the context. For behold, darkness shall cover the earth, and deep darkness the people, but the Lord will arise over you, and his glory will be seen upon you. What an amazing context that God knows. He's still sovereign, and he knew that this would happen, but he's also set his people all around the face of the earth. And this is our invitation to arise and shine at this moment. You know, I heard someone say this the other day, that in order for stars to shine, you need a really dark scenery. You need really dark sky so that that little one star can shine here, another star can shine here, another star can shine. And when there is a corporate individual, you know, star shining, it is a beautiful starry night. That's what we call it, you know. So we are all called in our individual light. You may think it's insignificant, but I want to encourage you, we're all together in this moment shining our lights with the glory of God. And you know, in the context of Jesus, every week they would read from the scriptures in the temple, and it was a systematic reading, and they would read through the scriptures throughout the whole year, and it was scheduled, and it says that when it was Jesus's turn to stand up at the podium and read the passage for that week, it was not Isaiah 60, it was Isaiah 61. And I began to think, perhaps Isaiah 61 is a response to Isaiah 60's invitation to arise and shine. When there's darkness, arise, shine, for your light has come. So here's what, in that context, Jesus heard that invitation the week before in the synagogue. And the next week, he gets up and reads Isaiah 61. He says, "The Spirit of the Sovereign Lord is upon me. He has anointed me to preach good news at this time." So I want to encourage our community, our Life Center, all of our families, all of our individuals who make up our corporate church here at Life Center, I want to encourage you that the Spirit of God has anointed us for this season. Be a voice of hope for your children. Be a voice of hope for your neighbors. Be a voice of hope for coworkers maybe who have lost jobs, for friends who have lost jobs. Perhaps I know business people here in our community have lost their business or are challenged during this time and are cutting back in so many ways. We want to be a shining lighthouse during this time. So be encouraged, shine bright, arise and shine bright, for the glory of God is upon us for such a time as this. God bless you.